All right, guys, I completely forgot to check our mouse trap because remember a couple days ago we saw evidence of mice poo. It's in my bathroom. Not sure how that worked. Oh, Mabuhay Squad. Check out the mouse trap.
Yes.
Hey guys, welcome to my daily vlogs. Please subscribe.
Yes, nothing's inside, just the bait. Okay, so this is a good sign. I don't think we have mice. Phew! I'm just gonna leave this out here just in case, but glad to know we don't have a mouse problem.
OMG, what is this, guys? Look what just came in. Check this out. It's a gift from BJ Pasquale Decors. Oh my! There are all of his social media handles and his phone number. This is going to be interesting. RJ, are we gonna open it now?
Yeah.
Ooh.
This is a big pancit bilao.
Pancit. I don't think it's food. Mabuhay Squad, this is pretty crazy.
Ooh.
Oh.
Ooh.
Oh my. Oh my gosh. Whoa. Oh, wow. It's so beautiful. Oh my gosh, guys. You know what this is? This is a parol. Okay, for those of you who are not Filipino, this is supposed to represent a star. Every Christmas, Filipinos hang like a decorative star. I know this looks like a flower, but usually it's different colors, reds, greens, and one of the signature parts of the star are the shells. See, that's all shell here.
Oh my god, it's beautiful.
Wow, it's like Dreamcatcher style parol. Oh, it's a plug-in, so it's got lights.
Yep.
Oh, good. Oh my gosh, this is gonna look so good by the window. OMG, RJ, this would look... We need to keep this for years and years. This would look awesome in the circular window in our future bedroom. Oh, it is so nice. And look at the knotting work. So apparently this is called macrame and it's like a certain type of knotting, I guess, art form or craft.
That's what BJ Pasquale specializes.
In the macrame. Oh, cool. Thank you so much, BJ Pasquale. This is beautiful. We've never had a parol in all these years that we've been here. It's a very, very traditional Filipino thing to hang these shell made stars on your window. So that is really, really nice.
So apparently this particular design or creation that BJ is named after the brightest star in the constellation of Auriga.
Oh, it's named after... So what's this named?
It's called Capella.
Capella. And, and that's the name of a star.
Sixth brightest star in the night sky.
Oh.
And the third brightest in the northern celestial hemisphere.
Oh, wow.
According to Wikipedia.
Interesting. I love this design, Capella. It is massive. Look, Mabuhay Squad, look how big this is. Oh, it's massive. It is so nice, guys. If you need beautiful macrame paroles like this Capella design, I believe he's got other designs, be sure to check out BJ Pasquale on social media.
Yeah, it's a very nice gift for Christmas.
Yeah, thank you. And BJ Pasquale, guys, is a Mabuhay Squad. Yay! BJ, if you're watching this, thank you so much. This is just unbelievable. The craftsmanship is just so crazy. It's very nice. Oh my gosh, it's so nice. That is so cool. Oh, it's so peaceful. I love that. Isn't that nice, Mabuhay Squad? This is such a nice parol. Cypher's like, what is that? he's looking at us. He's like, what's going on? Oh, this reminds me of like my mom who used to hang paroles on our window. So cool.
Good morning, guys. Ooh, it is early today. Early because today is sort of a big day. Oh, look at how nice the parol looks. So nice, this parol. Wow. Sun is setting. It's about just after 6 a.m. And it's a big day because today's the day I'll be Zooming with someone special, with, I guess, a special family. The other day I was like totally freaking out, right? I couldn't tell you who it was that I was speaking to arrange a Zoom chat. Still not sure if it's okay to like reveal, but I'll find a way to ask if it's okay to let you guys know who it is that we're Zooming with this morning, but it's just super duper cool. They are super nice, so something tells me it'll be okay to tell you, at least tell you. But I'm excited because this child that I'm Zooming is super passionate about ants and Ants Canada, the channel, they watch it. And I'm really, really excited to, you know, see that child sort of passion for nature and ants and stuff. So it reminds me of me when I was a kid. But I'm gonna run. I'm trying to be quiet because RG's still sleeping. I'm gonna run first so I can like wake up. And by the time I get back and I'm showered and I'm all ready, I think it'll be time for the big Zoom. Ooh. OMG guys, okay, this is the moment of truth. Gonna Zoom now. I'm gonna try to ask if we're allowed to reveal, but we'll see how it goes. Wish me luck, guys. Oh my goodness! Oh my goodness! RJ, what did you think of that?
That's cool. But that will be the same reaction if I Zoom with the Queen.
RJ!
England.
RJ's like, same reaction when I Zoom with the Queen of England. Okay, maybe they watch Ants Canada too. But oh my gosh. Okay, they said it's okay if I share this. Guys, I just Zoomed with the most brilliant kid. His name is Nate Groening, son of the Matt Groening, creator of The Simpsons. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Oh my goodness. Like just, guys, I'm beyond myself. They're such an amazing family. Matt and his wife, Augusta, they really support Nate's passion for ants. And listen, guys, Nate loves ants. He reminds me of me. He's got all kinds of ant farms. He knows species names. The kid is 7. He knows like what species have multiple queens. I was just mind blown through the whole thing. He's got like a ton of Ants Canada gear and just really great. Matt and Nate and Augusta, if you guys are watching this, thank you so much. I was just beside myself the whole time. But yeah, I mean, I hope to Zoom with them again. It sounds like we're just gonna keep in touch. But that is so cool that, well, first of all, that kid is an ant lover. So great, very promising for our next generation of leaders. But also that this show, The Simpsons, that I grew up watching since I was a kid, like since Nate's age. I mean, every night turning on the TV and watching The Simpsons, that was the staple. Some of my moral principles in life I learned from The Simpsons, you know? I identified with Lisa growing up. And here I was, like, Zooming with the family, with Matt. I can't get over it. I can't. This is just beyond, beyond, beyond. Anyways, Mabuhay Squad, wow. Wow. I'm just, wow. Wow. Like, super honored. RJ was too shy to get into the Zoom. He was just off to the side. Cypher, thank you for being quiet. Oh, Mabuhay Squad, really. Life is just full of surprises, isn't it? Oh my gosh! And I asked Matt if he was a, like, psychic or a time traveler, because The Simpsons has, like, predicted so many things many, many years before they actually happened, including Donald Trump becoming president, as an example. Oh my gosh! Also, I forgot to say, Augusta said she would send art, Simpsons art. Oh my gosh, and I hope they all sign it. Oh my gosh, we're gonna frame that and we're gonna put it in the studio of our future home. OMG, I hope they come and visit Philippines. Oh my gosh, Augusta, Nate, and Matt, and the whole family, if you guys ever come to the Philippines, we will take you guys around. You can stay with us in our aunt home. Ah! Oh my gosh, oh my gosh. Oh, I can't breathe. Okay, seriously, we need positive affirmation of the day. Okay guys, I need to breathe. Sunday, November the 22nd. Throughout the day, I check in on my body's tension level. I sit quietly, breathe deeply, and let the tension go. But this is like good tension, but yes, okay. Whew, I need to relax. Hope you guys enjoy today's positive affirmation and release the tension in your body. Another reason why this Zoom meeting with Nate and Matt and Augusta means a lot to me is because It couldn't be more timely because the other night, RJ and I, remember RJ, we were having a discussion on like motivation, being motivated for Ants Canada. Because when did lockdown start? Beginning of March, right? Usually I have our team members, production team members for Ants Canada, come over. They help me with filming, with editing. But since the lockdown, have not been able to have them come over. So I've been doing the Ant videos since the beginning of March. And of course, to upkeep the quality of the videos, I've got like a lot of work to do just on my own, and we release a video every week, right? So I have come close to burning out many times. So RJ and I often have these conversations where it's like, RJ, I'm burning out. I don't know what to do. Maybe I should skip a week. Or this conversation comes up regularly until things get back to normal where I can have my guys come over and help me. I have these frequent creator burnout breakdowns, right? But this Zoom couldn't have come at a better time because just the other night I had one of these breakdown moments and conversations with RJ, and then the universe made this happen, and all of a sudden now I'm like super inspired because it reminds me that, you know, there are like real people out there who take something from my work. From the sleepless nights, from the sweaty hours in the ant room filming, all of the hours it takes to edit, and it just reminds me that, you know, this is why I do the ant videos, because it somehow inspires people to, like, you know, appreciate nature. It brings families together. Matt and Augusta watch the ant videos with Nate too. Like, Matt was saying while he's working, Nate is watching the ant videos and hears my voice in the background. He said he couldn't believe he could hear me talking in just normal conversation because he's so used to hearing my voice from the ant videos. And that just blows my mind. Like, while Matt is working on The Simpsons, my videos is playing in the background. Like, it's crazy. Oh my goodness. And we talked. I mean, Matt is just so nice. He had so many great things to say about the Ants Canada videos. He says he loves the cinematography. He says he loves that it's story-based. And oh my gosh, the maker of The Simpsons saying that he appreciates the story of Ants Canada. Oh my, I'm just, hello, Matt is the storyteller. You know what I'm saying? I'm just like dead, guys. Like, I've lost control of my nervous system at this moment in time. I just, what an honor. But anyways, yeah, going back to what I was saying, this has inspired me to, like, it's given me sort of like a re-energizing wave of energy to, like, really push hard, keep pushing for the Ants Canada videos. Because, you know, I'm here editing it in, like, my little living room here, but I sometimes forget that the work gets spread out to, like, millions of people around the world. Like, that, the worldwide reach of YouTube, sometimes I forget this. You know what I'm saying? So that was a great reminder, and definitely a good motivational boost for me for the Ants Canada channel. And like, even yesterday, one of my greatest, like, LGBT idols, Tyler Oakley, OG YouTuber. Like, I retweeted one of his tweets and he was like, OMG, I can't believe you retweeted me. Have been watching your Ants Canada videos during quarantine and wow. And I was just like, what? You watch the Ant videos too? Oh my god. It just blows my mind, guys, really. Felicia Day, maybe a couple months ago, Felicia Day, another big celebrity, mentioned how much she's addicted to the Ants Canada videos. You know, like, this just blows my mind, blows. I think this year we've hit the trending tab in the US maybe 12 times, and even then it didn't kick in that, like, lots of people are actually watching the videos that I, like, kill myself to make. But now I don't see it like that now. Like, I see it as like, okay, I'm helping people, and somehow people are getting something from the videos. So, like, that's the biggest inspiration boost ever. Anyways, this was like such a big gift from the universe today, and exactly what I needed, what my spirit needed, my body, my mind needed. Woo! Guys, I smell something funky.
That's not me.
Are you sure it's not you, RJ? What is it?
I don't know.
Mabuhay squad. Some things smells not right. It's not in the fridge. It's not my pets. It's not the bathroom. Oh. OMG. RJ. Mabuhay squad. We found our smelly culprit. Check it out. Oh, ho, 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 ho.